Hi, Year 2 students. Welcome to lesson number 29. My name is Ella and I am your teacher today. What we'll need for today's lesson is your learning book and your pack of cards, please. And that's all we'll need, and away we go. Let's think about our recap from last lesson, which was consecutive numbers. And consecutive numbers are numbers that follow each other and they have a difference of one. So I can start at 126 and the next consecutive number is 127, 128, 129. They have a difference of one, minus one, or an addition of one. And we also looked at, with our staircases, we looked at odd and even consecutive numbers, and they have a difference of two. That's right, 2, 4, 6, 8, or 1, 3, 5, and 7. They have a difference of two. We got very good at that, and I hope you enjoyed your game of flipper, taking away one, taking away two. Right, let's get into our number talk. And our number talk today is with the use of a 100 chart. And you most likely have used one of these before. Here's a beautiful one, and we can see loads of patterns in a 100s chart. Today, we're going to practice the skill of subtracting 3. Okay, so we've done our minus 1, we've done our minus 2, we're ready for minus 3. Take away, subtract, minus 3. And we're going to pick some random numbers. So here we go with the randomizer. 34, we're going to take away 3. Let's hop back 3. 1, 2, 3. 34 minus 3, or 3 less than 34, is 31. Nice work. I sort of already knew that because I was thinking about 4 take away 3 and I came to the conclusion it was 1. So I made some mathematical judgment there. Okay, let's try another one. 77 minus 3. 77 minus 3. 1, 2, 3. 74, because I know 7 minus 3 will make the 4, and I'm in the line of 70s. One last one before it gets too tricky. 26. 3 less than 26. You're right, 23. Let's have a look. 1, 2, 3, 23. That magical number again. All right, let's take it up a level. I'm going to look at the number 72. I would like 3 less than 72. Can you see the difference? 1, I've got nowhere else to hop to. Ah, that's right. The number before 71 is 70. So let's go here again from 72. Let's jump 1, 2, 3. The number is 69. 72 minus 3 is 69. One last one for good luck. Let's go with 40. 40 minus 3. 40 minus 3. What's the number 1 less than 40? Here it is. 1, 2, 3. 40 minus 3 is 37. So lots and lots of practice subtracting 3, minus 3. Okay, all right. So that's a good number talk start for us today. Today's lesson, our learning intention is to apply our learning of difference. We can look at the gap or the difference when we look at data sets, and I have 3 data sets in front of me to help us practice. We'll know that we can do this when we can find the difference between amounts in different sets of data. Now let's remember, subtraction means take away, subtract, minus. All of those words mean we're going to remove something. And we've been looking at subtraction as difference. So my first example to show you is my collection of toys. Well, actually, there's one collection that belongs to my friend Maureen, and there's one collection that belongs to me. Now, Maureen has more toys than me. So this must be Maureen's collection. All right, let's see how many she has. I'm going to count again in twos. It's quicker than counting in ones, so here we go. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 1. 8 and 1 make 9. So Maureen has 9 toys, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or I could subitize and see that that's 5 straight away. So now the question is, what's the difference? How many more toys does Maureen have than I have? So Maureen has 9, I have 5. What's the difference between 9 and 5? What's the gap? How many more do I need? Let's count on from 5 to 9. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 4. 4 is the difference. So my number sentence could be 9 take away 5 equals 4. So there's my first data set. Okay. My second data set looks like this. Another one of my favorite topics, basketball. Okay, so we have 4 friends that have been playing games of basketball, and they can remember that they have played a certain amount of games. So Jay has played 3 games. Vinara has played 2 games. Charlie, 5, and Felix, 2. Okay, so let's have a look at some questions around this data. My first question is, how many more games has Charlie played than Felix? How many more games has Charlie played than Felix? What's the gap? What's the difference here? So our larger number is 5. 5 subtract or take away 2 will give me the gap. The gap is 3. Charlie has played 3 more games than Felix. Or Felix has played 3 less games than Charlie. We can do those comparisons with our sets of data. Okay. Here's another one. How many less games has Jay played than Charlie? How many less games has Jay played than Charlie? Let's look at these two sets. How many less? What's the gap? What's the difference here? How many less? Start with a bigger number. 5. Take away 3. 5 take away 3. Is 2. There are 2 here that are missing, that is less than. So the answer to the question is Jay has played 2 less games than Charlie. So we can use our data sets to do those wonderful comparisons. How many more, how many less? Okay, so there are lots of other questions that could go with that data set, but I think we can understand that we're looking for the difference. My last data set I've made, and you could make one too if you wanted to. So I have raided the sock drawers and found a collection of socks. Let's have a look. I have 5 black socks. I have 3 white socks. And I've got some crazy socks here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's check. 2, 4, 6, and 1 is 7. Beautiful. So I have 7 crazy socks. I have 3 white socks and I have 5 black socks. Now here comes some questions. We're going to look for the difference about more or few or less. Here we go. How many more crazy socks do I have than white socks? How many more crazy socks? So remember, we're looking for the difference. Let's start with a big number. 7, take away 3, 7 take away 3 is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have 4 more crazy socks than white socks. One more. Okay. Let's have a look at our white socks and our black socks. How many fewer white socks do I have than black socks? How many fewer? How many less? Let's look for the gap. Here it is. Here's the difference. Okay, so the difference between black socks and white socks, I can see, is 2. Let's check with this number sentence. Start with the largest number. 5 take away 3 will give me 2. That's right, there are 2 fewer white socks than black socks. But isn't it great? We've got more crazy socks than the rest of them. Great listening. Now let's get to the doing task. Let me quickly read our doing task for you. So, number 1, Grace had 17 ribbons. She gave 5 of them to Sanvi. How many ribbons does Grace have left? Ruby has 18 sultanas for recess and Zaid has 23 sultanas. How many more sultanas does Zaid have than Ruby? And the last doing task for you today, Ava has 7 fewer pencils than Ayan. Ava has 6 pencils. How many pencils does Ayan have? Don't forget to use our bar model and have a think about subtraction is a difference in those 2 amounts. Have a go and I'll see you when you're finished. Let's reflect on our learning today. Today we were able to find the difference between amounts using sets of data, and I think we did that really well. Our takeaway task today is another game of flipper. We're going to use the number 10 to minus what we have in our pack. So I need to take out my picture cards, make sure they're all out and popped away to the side. And here we go. My first card in my flipper game, 10 minus 10, 0. 10 minus 9, 1. 10 minus 9, 1. 10 minus 3, 7. 10 minus 8, 2. 10 minus 7, 3. I've got very quick at minusing from 10. I wonder if you can be that quick. Keep practicing, because the more you do, the quicker you become. I hope you enjoy the flipper game today. 10, subtract, minus, or take away the number you have. Okay, and I will see you next lesson.